Hello, welcome to the Fotis Trading Academy. In this presentation, I'm going to show you a three-step approach that is very similar to the way professionals in investment banks approach the markets. And if you stay disciplined and follow the guidelines, you will see a dramatic change in your performance. At the end of this presentation, you will be able to go off and do this for yourself, even if you are a complete beginner. We will show you how to get start trading like a true professional. The first step in your trading plan should be to understand the current financial and economic environment. What are the current economic conditions? What has been driving prices? Which theme of interest is currently acting as the catalyst that is moving the markets? You can't trade or invest successfully and consistently unless you are able to answer these questions and to be able to understand the overall sentiment. Imagine you are a Navy SEAL or a Special Forces Commando and they send you to a mission in a foreign land. Do you just rush out of your carrier or your plane, shooting and screaming and shooting randomly around you? You are not Sylvester Stallone in Rambo. What actually happens in reality is that you spent a significant time in preparation and planning and understanding the environment. What would be the weather like? What's the shape of the ground? Are there mountains or is there a desert? What's the firepower of the enemy, etc.? If you know in advance which pairs to concentrate on and which to ignore, that alone puts you way ahead of the vast majority of retail traders. That's why it's important to understand your environment. Once you discover how to do this for yourself, your trading results will improve exponentially. So, first we will look at what top-down trading is. And then I will show you some examples of how I'm using top-down trading and analysis to improve my investment decision-making. Now, let's get into it. The main theory idea behind top-down trading is that a rising tide lifts all boats. So if you can find where the tide is going up, then you can also find currencies that are going up. In my experience, the vast majority of retail traders have little or no idea of what is happening in the bigger financial picture. They focus too much on the short term, trying to capture insignificant moves and neglect bigger trends. I would also argue that all financial markets are interrelated, or at the very least can provide clues as to future movements not only in currencies, but equally in bonds, stocks, ETFs, currencies, and so on. Because this approach begins at the top, the first step is to determine the world economy's health. This is done by analyzing not only the developed countries, but also emerging ones. For example, a quick way to determine an economy's health is to look at the gross domestic product, or otherwise the GDP. And we are doing this over the past few years, and also we are looking at estimates going forward. Very often, emerging market countries will have better growth numbers when compared with their mature counterparts. So after we analyze which regions present a high reward to risk ratio, the next step is to look at the individual economies. By examining economic data such as interest rates, inflation, employment, and some other, we can determine the current market strength and have a better idea of what the future holds. There is often a divergence between the story the economic numbers tell and the trend of the stock market indices. The attached diagram shows my overall approach. Myself, like most fund managers and professional traders that I know, use what is called a top-down approach. This means that I formulate a big picture view And then I apply specific strategies to fit that overall macro outlook. There are a huge number of variables that go into this formulation. For example, what is the government or central bank doing? Where are earnings going? What are the inflation, deflation trends? How is the global economy impacting the markets? A great deal of understanding and education is required for this sort of approach. If you don't understand where interest rates are headed, you won't know where bond prices are going. Markets are highly interconnected. If you don't understand the bond market, I would argue that you probably understand the currency markets less than you think. In order to help you understand this better, this is an example of our analysis that we carry out at our investment meetings every Monday morning. Now, please don't feel overwhelmed. It's not difficult at all, and we teach all our students to do this during the weekends, so they have a clear plan for the coming week and they know exactly what is going on in the markets. By doing this, we can examine and identify how the sentiment is changing and shifting from one extreme to the other. We can say with pretty high precision what do other traders or investors think and to which developments do they pay attention. One of the key characteristics of successful traders is their ability to understand what others are considering at the time and in which way it is more likely for them to behave. In our example right here, is it the hiking of interest rates in the United States that will be the dominating theme in the markets? Or is it the status of the Chinese economy? There are other times that an unexpected political or economic event, an emerging market crisis, or the result of an election can significantly affect the markets and cause turbulence. So if we are aware what is happening and what is the current economic environment, you can identify with pretty high precision which markets or assets will move. For example, don't you think that the US dollar will move if there is a change in interest rates policy by the US Fed? Or if there is an extreme negative sentiment in the markets, equities are moving down, and there is pessimism, then it is very likely that investors will move into safe haven assets, such as the yen, for instance. All it is required is a basic understanding of inflation and interest rates. Firstly, higher interest rates indicate a strong economy, and investors are more likely to invest into an economy that is growing. The demand for local currency is therefore likely to increase, which can lead to an increase in its value. Higher interest rates, therefore, increase the demand for the currency of the country, and so it does appreciate in value. However, this is under normal economic circumstances. Now, if there is a country and it is experiencing deflation, and that means that prices actually fall, investors could also see this as an indicator that the economy is performing poorly. Therefore, this can also have a negative effect on the value of the currency. Central banks tend to target a specific rate of inflation. A central bank will try to target an acceptable level of inflation, for example around 2-3%. If the inflation rate is reported to be within the target range, the currency value does not tend to react very much. The currency value reacts much more if the inflation rate is drastically outside this range. To protect consumers from excessive inflation, central banks will tend to raise interest rates. This is because, as explained above, it reduces the spending power that consumers have, so the prices for goods and services decrease under the reduced demand. Now, the point is, and what you can understand from this, that inflation is moving up and down, and interest rates that are set by the central bank, they adjust accordingly, and this is affecting the value of the currency that you want to trade. So the two most important economic indicators that you need to understand is interest rates and inflation. And when we say interest rates, that also means central bank policy. What is the monetary policy in that country? How is this affecting interest rates? And also, what is the inflation regime in the country that you wish to examine, in the country that you wish to trade its currency? Do we have very low levels of inflation, or are we in a strong inflationary environment? So if you understand these two simple economic indicators, and at Fotis Trading Academy, we will make everything we can to help you succeed in this. You will understand very well in which way are the markets heading. At the Fotis Trading Academy, we will show you how to clearly analyze the markets using fundamentals and how to also use the economic calendar. We will give you a very specific framework, so you will not be trading randomness. You will have a very specific framework to analyze the markets based on 9 major economic indicators. But please take into consideration that you do not need to be an economist or a mathematician. Thank you.